Welcome to another video in the series about hiking trails. This one is not really about mapping, but it is how to use data from OpenStreetMap. So imagine you want to download a track or a trail from OpenStreetMap. Obviously, you can't do that just from openstreetmap.org. You can, I think, do that on all trails, for example, which is partly OSM-based. But I have talked to someone who hikes regularly, and she said that you download these tracks, and it's just people have just traced where they were walking, and they might have taken shortcuts, or they might have gone into somewhere, into a pub on the way, or used a facility or something like that, and they're sometimes a bit useless. So if you download a route relation from OpenStreetMap, you're much better off. And you can do that in several ways. You can do it in Overpass Turbo, for example, and that's a bit more technical, but I'll talk to you about another more simple possibility later. So on Overpass Turbo, if you want to make it visible, one of those route relations, you can do that by using the wizard as usual. Click on wizard and you're looking for the name of your loop. One of the obstacles here is that you have to know the name of the loop and spell it correctly, or hope that the person who mapped it also spelled it correctly. But I mapped two trails here in the Castle Comer Discovery Park last weekend, so I know how I spelled it, so hopefully it'll work. So it's called Captain's Loop, and for some reason there's no apostrophe. I'm sure they know what they're doing. And I will click on Build Query here and delete these two lines, node and way, because we don't need them as before, and I will hit Run. And there is the trail. And if I click on the fuchsia pink line, it'll give me some information, color red. And I've talked about all these in the video about the relations, and you can watch that. I'll link it up in the box. So color red, that's the color of the marker for the trail. Distance 2.5 kilometers, dogs leashed. That's something I haven't talked about, not that value anyway. But there are several signs along here that dogs need to be kept on a leash, so I added that. And then I also have a papillary sequence here, because I went around and took papillary pictures, so you can go virtually, name, network type, hiking route, type route, and so on. So this is all nice, and you can't really take a screenshot. Well, you could probably take a screenshot and walk along that. It's not very high-tech. But you could also export this by clicking on export up here on the left, and you can download the GPS here. So you can download the data, which is usually what you need in your app, or a map or a query. But in this case, we want the GPX track, or KML, which I think is more used on Google Maps. Don't use Google Maps. So you can download that here by just clicking download, and then you do whatever you have to do with your app. I don't know. I don't do it that way. So this is a little bit technical because there's code involved and that might frighten you off. But I want to show you a website. It's called waymarkedtrails.org. Waymarkedtrails is one word, .org. And it was written by a lady in Germany, Sandra, who lives in Dresden. And I got in contact with her recently and had a few questions about how often it is updated and so on. And I'm just thrilled that it was a woman who wrote this. So you can choose between all these types of routes. Remember when we did the relation, when we created the relation, we put in route equals hiking. And these are other things you can put in. But since this series is about hiking, I'm going to stick to hiking. And if I click on that, it opens the map, OpenStreetMap, obviously, and I've already zoomed in before on Castle Comer, the Discovery Park, and you see that there are two loops or two trails mapped here. This is the longer one. This is the one I actually walked. It's called the Ardra Loop because there is a townland somewhere here that's called Ardra, and the lines are both purple, I guess, violet. And you see it has these letters here, and AL stands for Ardra Loop, so she always uses an abbreviation. And CL stands for Captain's Loop, and that's the one that we have here. I can zoom out a little bit. And she just she updates that I think by the minute, and it is just displayed here. And if you, I'll just zoom out for a little bit. It has all hiking trails, obviously only the ones that are mapped in Ireland, so there's still a lot to do. And if you zoom out, you see that the small ones here in Castlecomer have vanished, because it only shows the national ones and the international ones here. So there's the E8, that's a European hiking trail. And maybe these ones are mapped as national, but should maybe be regional or local. And then we have the Barrowway here, walked parts of that. And you have the symbol here is a little hiker, a yellow hiker. And if you zoom in more, you get more options, more hiking trails shown. If you remember, if you've been watching all my videos, probably haven't. So here's the Freshford Loop on the left here. And this one here is one I did sometime last year. This is the math pass that leads from the Bleach Road to Dunmore Church in County Kilkenny. So because I mapped that as a hiking trail, that also turns up. And it's a really long abbreviation. But anyway, back to Castlecomer. So let's say the Captain's Loop, so CL, I can click on that, hopefully. Yeah, and it's on the side, it opens this menu here. And if I hover over it, I didn't even know that before. If I hover over the name Captain's Loop, it gets a yellow highlighter around it, and the Ardra Loop as well. And I can click on Captain's Loop here, and you can do the same on your phone. I've tried that earlier. It says here, I had all the information that I put in earlier, mapped length 2.2 kilometers. So it just measures that. And official length 2.5 kilometers. So that's the information I found on trailkilkenny.ie. And if you compare that to the Ardra Loop, the mapped length is 4 kilometers, but on the official website it says 6 kilometers, which is quite a difference. That's about half an hour walking, maybe 20 minutes if you're a fast walker. But yeah, so I don't know how they measured that on Trail Kilkenny. Let's go back to the Captain's Loop. And then we have the color red, distance 2.5 kilometers, dog leashed, papillary, doesn't turn up as a link name, and so on. And down here, at the very bottom, you can download the GPS and the KML files. And I think this is a pretty neat site if you want to plan your hiking route. And I haven't actually tried this now, but I presume you can also search for them, hopefully. Freshford Loop. Yeah, so that works. It's good to know. If at the bottom left here, you can type in the name of the trail, and maybe it will also find it if I just type in Freshford, in case I don't know it's a loop. Yeah, so it finds a lot of results here for Freshford. Not all of them are in County Kilkenny, but it will definitely also show the Freshford Loop. And if I want to type in Gorman from last time when I mapped the O'Gorman's Loop, so see, it brings up O'Gorman's Lane Loop. So that's pretty neat, I think. And I'll let you go and try that out yourselves. Waymarkedtrails.org. And then you can choose hiking, or you can type in hiking.waymarkedtrails.org from the start. And happy exploring, happy hiking, and happy mapping, and I hope to see you in the next video. Slán!